Here is our quick tree tool. So by clicking on the tool, we can also see a curve. So this curve, if we go to edit mode, we can control where actually this is going. So we can have a quite user-friendly control in how my tree is going. Then further, you can see that the style at the moment is also set to a more low poly style. So we have here a lot of settings where I can start fine-tuning what the output should be. So in here, first of all, we have the growing number. So it's set to 3 right now, but you can also lower this. So in here, we have some options to then increase, for example, the poly count, make it more high poly. What we can also do here is disable the leaves, and we can here actually add the other leaves. So these are just plain parts, and I'm going to have to give them a material. So then here further we have branch control, so you can lift here the branches, so basically some rotation there. You can also start twisting them. As you can see, we can twist them around to get more variation. We also can decide where to start the grow of the branching. So if I increase the start, you can see that the distance from the beginning here is increased, so you can define that growth. And also finally, we have here also a color. Then further here, we are having the leaves. So I'm going to enable my leaves. You're going to also have to assign a material. So my path is now set. I can also play around here with the seed. Then here is the amount of branches. Then here is the amount of leaves. So right now it's around 115, which in this case is too low. So I'm going to increase this to around 300 probably. So that means there will be 300 clusters. And you can see that this gives us a really nice result for a quick branch tool. Then we can also push up the model, so we can lower or push this up. I like to push it up a little bit, so we can see some more of the branching going on. Then here we have a color, so and the color is mainly then used here to control this. But it can also be used here as well. So if I play actually around with this value, you can see that I use the vertex color in this current shader to color this as well.